From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good evening. Welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Investigators are learning more about a logging truck that crashed in the town of Jackman overnight that sent logs rolling into a house, killing a 5-year-old boy. The Somerset County Sheriff's Department says the truck was passing through Jackman near the Canadian border at about 2:30 this morning. Tuesday, when it struck telephone poles, it rolled over and spilled its logs. The sheriff's department says the son of the house, of the owner of the house, Liam Mahaney, was sleeping on the downstairs couch and he was struck and killed. The truck driver, 57-year-old Christian Cloutier of Quebec, was taken to Bangor Hospital with unknown injuries. Cloutier told the sheriff's department that he fell asleep at the wheel. A 19-year-old soldier from Maine has been killed in Afghanistan. The Department of Defense says that Private Tyler Springman from Heartland died Sunday in the Kandahar province from wounds caused by a roadside bomb. Another soldier from Pennsylvania was also killed in that bombing. Springman was assigned to a combat team of the 25th Infantry Division at Fort Wainwright in Alaska. He graduated in 2010 from Nokomis Regional High School in Newport. School officials say that Springman was intent on enlisting in the Army out of high school and signed up shortly after graduation. A Lewiston man did not enter a plea during his initial court appearance on a murder charge. Bob Ryder of Lewiston is charged with murder in the death of Danita Brown from New Gloucester. State police say that Brown's body was found in the basement of Ryder's apartment building on Main Street in Lewiston last week. According to an affidavit, Ryder hit Brown over the head with a clock. Police believe that Brown may have been dead for several weeks before her body was found. A testimony in the Dewa Batsitsi murder trial ended this afternoon. Closing arguments are set to start tomorrow. He's the Portland man accused of shooting and killing Serge Malongo in February of last year. Meantime, the Attorney General's office says the gun used to kill Malongo is the same weapon used in another unsolved Portland murder. Investigators traced the gun as the same one used to shoot Darian Richardson a month earlier. Richardson was shot during a home invasion at a Portland apartment. She died 2 months later from a blood clot caused by the wound. Well, a judge has denied convicted killer Jason Tortis's motion for a new trial. Tortis was convicted last year of murdering his former fiancee, Kelly Gorham of Alfred. Gorham disappeared in August of 2007. Her body was found a few weeks later on property in New Hampshire, which was owned by Tortis's father. An autopsy showed that she had been strangled. Tortis has maintained his innocence. The Maine Turnpike Authority says its former executive director misused nearly $500,000 in turnpike funds in the form of gift cards, credit card charges, and vacation and sick leave pay that he was not entitled to. The authority filed a civil lawsuit Tuesday against Paul Violette, who resigned in March. The suit claims that Violette cannot account for $160,000 worth of gift cards for upscale hotels and restaurants and fraudulently converted at least $90,000 of them for his personal use. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Stay with us. The latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.